The second way of modeling is using parameter estimation bottom. In this method, ETAP will estimate the motor parameter based on the nameplate data. Nameplate data means the parameters in the nameplate and impedance page, which we have entered. These parameters are based on the nameplate, but trip device is a kind of onboard relay that can trip the circuit breaker. Select the CPU doesn't have any trip device. Let's select another model which has trip device. There are different type of trip device. It can be thermal, magnetic, solid state, motor type, and electromechanical. In the previous session, we have set the time delay over current phase, or NC51. In this session, we are going to set the instantaneous phase over current, or NC50. If you select FLA of an element or full load ampere of an element, then we can select the current of which element should be considered for cable sizing. Let me show you this with an example. I copy this cable to have the same parameters. Pick megavar and kilovar rating of the generator. These parameters are used for alerts in the motor acceleration, and I will explain more about this in the motor acceleration session. Yes, as you can see, 11.547 kiloamp is the short circuit current in this bus bar. This value is equal to the short circuit rate of the power grid. If we change the power grid short circuit rate, then this current also will be changed. You have to set minimum values, then the function do not pick up due to these noises. Okay, now let's inject the three-phase voltage and current to the relay. Yes, here in the relay HMI, primary value are showing, and in the quick CMC module, the secondary value are showing. Maximum fault or short circuit is approximately 2800 amp. Here is 3-phase current without fault and AG fault happening at this time. As you can see, in the first half cycle, fault current is maximum and the peak is also in this period. This period is called subtransient time, 1.5. Yes, this one is 7SKIT relay. In the XE4 training, I have explained how to configure the relay. First, you should activate each function in the device configuration. Here we can see the trip elements and equipment image curve, so we can analyze these curves and see which element will trip first. Same function, DMT, definite time, or instantaneous, or NC50 are also the same. Let's open the configuration software, accelerator quick set, and add a relay SCL format. In ETAP, this parameter is showing better, and the standard curve name is also mentioned with the. These overcurrent functions are connected to the CT according to the diagram. Overcurrent functions are not using the summation of the CTs. But we have seen as soon as the current reached 2 amp, the relay issued a trip signal. I've configured the trip signal as unlatch in output 1, and you know unlatch is second. This time is the maximum time that the lower level relay should clear the fault. Pre the time step. Like an event viewer in the substation automation system. Here also we can see the event happening with the timestamp. With this time delay, 56.7 milliseconds, relay 6, element 50. In this session, we are going to set ground element 50N and 51N elements. In the ground, as we can see, I0 is almost 0. So we cannot detect this type of fault with the ground element in the relay. This one is a 3-phase CT and this one is a core balance CT. Connected to terminal number 55 and 56. Natural element use the phase CT to calculate I0, but ground element use the core balance CT to measure I0. The setting of these two elements stages and one IDMTE, or inverse time ground, or 51 stages. If you wanted to coordinate a relay with a fuse, it is better to use extremely inverse. In the previous session, we have seen how to add fuse, overcurrent phase, and ground elements. In this session, we are going to overview the protection tab in each element. Inrush current in the primary amp is showing here. This value is 8 times of the FLA in the primary. Yes, FLA in the primary side is 18.19, Keras 18 is 145 amp. This black contains filters and functions to convert voltage and current to the sequence values. Sequence value, I mean positive, negative, and zero sequences. This block contains functions to convert sequence value to impedance value for phase and ground. And here we can see impedance value for each phase and ground loops, which is a P121. If we take 2 times of pickup current, the relay should trip at 0.667 seconds. In a real test, we should inject the pickup current. This value